Hi there. So today I'm going to just show you a little bit about this painting and kind of tell you kind of what my process is here. Last week or a couple weeks ago, I showed you a painting that I'm working on with a drawing that I started with and then how it kind of evolved from there. And I do the same thing here. I started out with this one single drawing right here, this single image, and then I just repeat it. So it's going from what I consider to be like the west, to the north, to the east, and to the south. And so then they interconnect in the middle, and I adapt it so that they all kind of work together, and it's kind of in a movement, and it creates a sense of interconnection and movement with one shape to the other and one direction to the other, and all being really one thing. And so it's kind of what art is, it's kind of what a mandala is, and it's just my interpretation of what this is all about. So this is just the start. With every time I do a painting like this, this kind of a painting, I have to take each section and paint it twice so that it's a solid color here. And then I come in with the details. So the next time I see you and I show this to you, I'll bring the detail and I'll show it to you how it's gonna unfold, because I'm just kind of getting an idea about what that is. So as I paint these paintings, it's kind of fun because I start with one idea. I have kind of this general idea what I'm going to do. Start with colors, and it's like, how does this work? I've got light colors, dark colors, negative shapes, form, you know, the texture, whatever it is. All those different principles of art, and trying to bring this together and seeing how I can pull this together. And I have ideas about what I want to do with this later, and I will tell you about that when that comes into fruition. But it's a kind of a fun process, because as I'm doing this, it takes on a momentum of its own. And it's like, well, this color doesn't necessarily look good, or that shape isn't necessarily right. Let's alter it. Let's change it. Let's see what happens. And that's kind of the case here. This color right here, I'm going to do something different here, because it's way too much blue. It's kind of a periwinkle color. And it's a nice color, but it doesn't make all of this pop. It kind of blends in way too much. So I'm going to do something different, and so I'll bring it back next time, and I'll show you what I do. I have some signature things that I do with these particular types of paintings that I always have to add in, and I haven't done that part yet. That's part of the detail. So everything that I do is really kind of a metaphor. I kind of think of, you know, art as a metaphor for life. You know, how do the principles of art, you know, how to color, shape, texture, movement, repetition, hue, shade, all those different things, negative space, positive space. How do you take all those different things and make them work in a painting? You take that same idea when you're doing photography, you know, and how you make sure you frame whatever it is you're looking at, and you've got it juxtaposed just right, so you get you know, using the principles of some principles of photography, of which I still am learning. And so I just take those things and do what it is I do. All of my book covers are my own photography, or there are my own art. So I apply what it is I'm doing to whatever it is, whatever else it is I'm doing in life. So I take my writing and my art, put it together. And I'm a storyteller, and that's a lot of what I do in these videos, is tell you about a story, tell you about the story of my art, tell you the story of what it is I'm doing, and tie it all in together. And the whole idea is to create something, an idea, and something in your mind where that works for you in your own way, and how you can take that and generate something in your life that's enjoyable, that's fun, that brings you into a place of happiness, a place of creativity, of innovation, of where you can come into your life and make this grand item, this grand thing, whatever that might be. It might be cooking an amazing dinner for yourself and for your family. It might be fixing a meal for one of your animals, where it's just kind of fun and different than what normally it would be. Like one year, for our cat's first birthday, we made them a little, it looked like a little cat cake, and all it was two different types of canned food stacked on each other with dry food in between and a candle. So it looked kind of like a chocolate cake, and then they munched down on it. It was kind of funny. So anyway, you can be creative. Make it fun. Make it enjoyable. Make it like a journey, an adventure, whatever that might be, whatever your task is. If it's something in your job, if it's something you're doing with your family, do something different. Do something unique. Try something new on for size and see what it is you can come up with, and look for the surprises. Look for the joy. Look for the happiness. I used to have a business where I made and sold jewelry. I bought beautiful pieces like pendants and things that other people made. And then I bought chain and I bought beads and I bought all these things. And I combined all those pieces together and made these really pretty pieces of jewelry. And I used to sell them in Costco stores for 2 years, in the Colorado Costco stores for 2 years. I sold in galleries. I sold in craft shows. Couldn't really sell in art shows because it wasn't my art. I'd taken other pieces and made it into something to sell, but I could sell it as in a craft show. So I've done that for years. And so I'm back at it with things like this and how we can turn it into something even greater still. And I use some of it in my books. I've got some other ideas of what I've got, what I can do. And if you have any ideas for me, please let me know. Write it down below, you know, in the section here. You can private message me. Let me know maybe some ideas that you can see for me. Maybe there are things I'm not really kind of thinking of right now, and I'd love to get your feedback on that. But whatever it is you're doing, make it something you enjoy, something that gives you life, something that you can do in just a different way, just tweak it just a bit, have a different perspective. How can you be innovative? How can you make this into a more creative outlet for you? Maybe an even more exciting way of doing what you do. Change it up. Add something new. Have fun with it and enjoy it. And just feel the how it generates energy within you when you do that. Feel how that brings you to a place of like, yeah, look at what I've done here. And then share it with other people and see how you can bring joy to other people as well. Life is good. And truly, we really are all in this together. And we can do it in our own different way. And then we can honor each other for the differences that we have. Honor each other for what it is that we're doing. And be happy for each other for the good that's going on in our lives. And for our experience and for what it is we're doing. And that's called sympathetic joy. When you want to do something that brings you joy, but you also want the same type of happiness for other people, other beings, all sentient beings. It's called sympathetic joy. Isn't that beautiful? So go out there and be happy. Go out there and be joyful. And know what you're doing brings joy to other people, and that you can also bask in their joy, even if you're not personally involved in what they're doing. You can watch what they're doing. You can read it in a book of what they're doing. You can see their beauty, their beautiful art or their photography on online or on some kind of social media, and celebrate what they're doing. Be out there and just say yes to life. Life is good. We're all in this together. And as Grandma used to say, love you bunches. Bye for now.